Now second is our full stop, and it is also known as period. Okay, and this is the sign of a full stop. Okay, one dot. Okay, this is the sign of a full stop. So when we will use full stop? At the end of statement and imperative sentence. Okay, so whenever we are writing any statement, at the end of that we will use full stop, and in imperative sentence also we will use full stop at the end. Okay, for example, the sun rises in east. So this is your statement and the sentence ends here. So after it, what we have used? One dot. This is your full stop. Okay, next, imperative sentence. For example, go there. Okay, so here I am giving one command. So this is your imperative sentence. So at the end I have used full stop. So in your imperative statement and imperative sentence, at the end you will use full stop. Okay, next, we will use full stop in abbreviations or initials. Abbreviation, it is the short form of many words. So we write in short form. So they are your abbreviations. So in abbreviation and in initials also we use full stop. Okay, you have seen. For example, GDMIS. When we will write GDMIS in short, this way we will write. So after every letter we will put a full stop. One dot. G dot, D dot, M dot, I dot, F dot. Okay, so this way we will get dot. Same way, V dot, I dot, P. This is your abbreviation. This is the short form for very important person. So we write VIP for that. Okay, so V dot, I dot, P dot. So after every letter I have used dot. So in abbreviation we use dot. Initials also we use dot. Mr. KPS Gill. In this also you can see after Mr. dot is there. Then K dot, P dot, S dot, Gill. Okay. So in this also we use full stop, or you can say we use period sign. Okay, period mark. So when we use full stop? At the end of a statement and imperative sentence and abbreviation or initials. Okay. Now next is our question mark. Now next is our question mark. So question mark, this also we have studied in our kinds of sentence we have studied. So question mark, this is the sign. One circle type this and one dot. So this is the sign of question mark. So now question mark, when we use it in interrogative sentence, at the end of interrogative sentence. Okay, जब हम कोई question पूछते हैं तो question type वाला जो भी हमारा sentence होता है तो उस question के बाद हम at the end we use question mark. Yes, and we all, for example, we see here, what is your name? So this is your interrogative sentence. So in this, after means at the end we use question mark. Okay, so whenever we are asking a question, it is an interrogative sentence, then we use question mark. Understood? Next, exclamation mark. So exclamation mark, this is your exclamation mark. One straight line and then we give one dot. This is your exclamation mark. This we use whenever we are writing exclamatory sentence. We use exclamation mark at the end of exclamatory sentence. Okay? And we also use exclamation mark in interjection. Okay? When we use interjection, at that time also, after every interjection, we use one exclamatory mark. Okay? For example, see, what a nice house. So this is your exclamatory sentence. So at the end I have used exclamation mark. Okay? Ouch. This is your interjection. So here an exclamation mark. Hooray. So after hooray there will be one exclamation mark. Vendor. Bravo. So all these are your interjection. Okay? The word which we used for expressing some sudden feeling. Okay, for appraising, for expressing our sudden feeling, that word is our interjection. Okay, and then after interjection also we use exclamatory mark. Understood? हम लोग हमेशा exclamatory sentence के बाद और interjection के बाद हम क्या use करेंगे? Exclamatory sign use करेंगे. Understood? Okay. Now let us study about comma. Okay. Now comma. So what is the meaning of comma? Comma, it is a small pause. Okay, like full stop. Full stop, it is your long pause. When we have to give a long pause, we write full stop. Okay, and comma, it is your small pause. When we have to give a small, a brief pause, then we use comma in sentence. Okay, and where else we use comma? For example, we use comma for series of words. For example, the words, they are from the same thing, and different words are there of a same thing. For example, like I love mango, orange and banana. So here you can see mango, orange, banana, these all things are from fruits only. So when we are telling two or three things of same series, so to separate that series of words, we use comma. Okay, so I love mango, comma, orange and banana. And while reading also, what we do in comma, we give a small pause. Okay, a brief pause. I love mango, orange and banana. Okay, next, addressing a person or thing. So whenever we are addressing any person or anything, at that time also we use comma after the word, after the name of that person or the thing. For example, Suman. Suman, listen to me. So here I am talking to Suman and I am saying something. I am addressing. Main Suman ko bula rahi hu yahan pe, hai na? Suman se kuch keh rahi hu. So after Suman, I will give one comma. Suman, listen to me. Okay? So after Suman, there will be a comma. Why? Because here we are addressing a person. Main Suman se bol rahi hu. Suman ko address kar rahi hu. Okay? Next, separate parts of sentence. So whenever we have to separate the parts of sentence, at that time also we use comma. For example, Suman said, comma, I love my country. So here the part of sentence, it is separated. Suman said, it is different, and I love my country, this part is separated. Okay, so whenever we are separating the parts of a sentence, at that time also we use comma. Suman said, after said, there will be a comma. This is one part of the sentence. And I love my country. This is the second part of the sentence. Okay? So, why comma is used? Comma is used for a brief or for a small pause. Okay? At that time, we use comma. And where it will be used? For separating the series of words. Okay? Addressing a person or a thing. And separating parts of a sentence. At that time also we will use comma. Okay? Now let us study about colon and semicolon.